Good morning, everyone. My name is Kashmira DATE. I'm with the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and have been the chair of the OCV working group since last year. So some of this information has been provided already, so I'm going to try to, you know, stick to the key updates. So just as a quick reminder, these were some of the recommendations and a proposed work plan that came out of the GTFCC annual meeting last year pertaining to OCV. So looking at you know, the country support, and we'll hear more on the platform and what's being proposed, overall there was agreement that the OCV request should be considered as part of a national cholera control plan. And there was a need for revised processes, including OCV, that should be implemented together. There was, again, a recommendation to have technical guidance to support the development of cholera control plans, which include OCV as one of the pillars. And as Francisco already mentioned, we will hear about this tomorrow. There was also a recommendation to look more at the OCV WASH integration component and what that means. You know, there was a recommendation again to look at a technical note on what OCV, on what WASH measures should be implemented as part of OCV campaigns. So we'll hear a little bit more on that too. As Dominique mentioned already and Fran alluded to, the Wellcome Trust DFID support, we heard more about that last year in terms of the research agenda support. And then finally, for OCV, the big component is, again, the Gavi support and the vaccine investment strategy. So very quickly, as Dominique already showed us, what we are seeing in terms of the trends for OCV request and support, just, you know, this has been growing quite a bit. And as of May, you know, the latest data that we have, already about 14 million doses have been requested and 10 million have been shipped. So we are seeing that, you know, really large increases. But again, you know, the key message here is that we are still seeing that the demand exceeds, you know, what the supply has been. And I'm glad he answered the question on what are we going to do about the OCV supply. So in terms of the major developments and updates since the last meeting, from the last annual GTFCC meeting, we will hear more on the development, the framework for development on the national cholera control plans, which include OCV, as well as the monitoring and evaluation components related to that. A draft technical guidance note on integration of WASH and community engagement activities with OCV that's been developed in collaboration, primarily led by the WASH Working Group, and Monica will be presenting on that tomorrow as well. There was a Wellcome Trust DFID research agenda meeting that happened in July last year, and following that, you all have seen the call for proposals, and we'll hear more from the Wellcome Trust on the 5th about, you know, the follow-up of the call for proposals and the funding that has been provided. Again, a lot of work that went into defining the Gavi 2019-2020 support and the vaccine investment strategy, and I will give a few key updates on the what came out of the OCV working group meeting from December. So very quickly, I think all of you have already seen this slide from the GTFCC research agenda meeting from July. I've highlighted here in red the ones that are directly or indirectly relevant to OCV use. And, you know, we'll hear more about a lot of these activities that are happening. Quite a bit of, I think, the multi-sectoral collaboration needs to happen here also within the different areas of work. And as you can see, already we are talking about the OCV WASH integration, you know, again, surveillance being a key component in terms of targeting the vaccine use, and then how do we use that surveillance and the methods that are being developed for OCV impact assessments. So, you know, just highlighting some of the key outcomes that came out of the meeting in terms of prioritization of the research agenda. So, and we'll talk more about this tomorrow. I will be giving a presentation on accessing the global OCV stockpile. Just very, very quickly, 2018 was the year of VIS. We did see that cholera made it to the shortlist, and a number of experts around the room from GTFCC, the OCV working group, were consulted in terms of the vaccine investment strategy and provided some key input into that. So finally, I think, you know, again, Gavi has decided to support OCV through preventive immunization campaigns in hotspots. The final executive board decision will be happening this month. which included bridge funding again for continued use of OCV, the stockpile in 2019 and 2020, and includes some funding for the research agenda as well. Now, there are additional considerations. We will talk more on this in detail tomorrow, looking at, again, this is contingent upon sufficient replenishment of the Gavi funds. The support will be given to the GTFCC validated national cholera control plans. There is the Gavi Independent Review Committee, the Gavi processes to be followed with that, and then again the co-financing, which was discussed quite a bit during the OCV working group meeting as well. So some very key updates of and recommendations that came out of the December meeting. I think it's really interesting and very, very encouraging to note some of the vaccine-related updates. So, you know, WHO has now approved the package update, package insert updates for Shankol, as you can see here on, you know, again, which includes special populations, the CTC requirement, dosage, clinical efficacy, all of that will be included in the package insert updates. Although, I mean, you know, we saw that the supply is quite constrained, it's still, I mean, you know, just looking at over the number of years, the vaccine availability has really increased. Uvicol has ramped up their production quite a bit. And, looking at the presentation of the vaccine, they have done quite a bit of enhancements to the vaccine with you know, the presentation in terms of Uvicol Plus. So that's quite encouraging. Some other key updates is to continue working with Gavi. We are, as part of the OCV working group, working with Gavi to frame the OCV investment and its linkages to the ending cholera roadmap. One of the key concepts and one of the key areas of work that was identified is to, again, facilitate very close involvement with immunization programs. There has been limited engagement on that end with terms of, the EPI programs, you know, looking at some of the models with GPEI, the Global Polio Eradication Initiative. So, some work to be done on that. And then there was a recommendation to establish a small group to look at developing that OCV WASH integration guidance and linkages to the long-term WASH component as well. So finally, in terms of our next steps, we will be working very closely again with Gavi in terms of framing the Gavi, the upcoming support through Gavi for the preventive campaigns. Continue to provide country support for OCV campaign implementation, planning implementation, monitoring and evaluation through the GTFCC platform and the roadmap. Again, as I mentioned, I think there is we need to closely collaborate with the other working groups, the surveillance working group for targeting of hotspots, impact assessments, and the WASH working group with the integration piece. We have already looked at some of these research agenda priorities and how do you build adequate monitoring, evaluation, and ongoing research plans and try to look at them all together. And then last but not the least is, to continue some work to try to engage additional manufacturers on new vaccine formulations that could be, I mean, it's going to take time, but will be, an important step to looking at the whole availability issue and how the vaccine is used in the future. So that's all. Thank you very much.